Peter Szabo in lane one, who is no relation to the other Szabo from Hungary swimming in the race, incidentally. John Cleveland of Canada is in lane two. Barrowman from the USA in lane three. Nick Gillingham of Great Britain was the fastest qualifier. There's the world record time set 4 years ago at Los Angeles by Victor Davis of Canada. And the Olympic record time, one and the same. Barrowman, who set that American mark in qualifying at Austin, Texas in August. The Olympic trials here. And there's Mike Barrowman. He's in lane three. Gillingham was the fastest qualifier. He swims in lane four for Great Britain. Joseph Szabo, Valerie Lozek of the Soviet Union, Sergio Lopez of Spain, and Vadim Alexeyev of the Soviet Union is at the bottom of your screen, swimming in lane eight.
No, Don, not only is it a coincidence that the three characters in the race are all trained by the same guy, they all have a distinctive stroke. It's either called the rollover stroke, or some people call it the Hungarian wave, where the swimmers, when they pull their arms together, raise their hands close to the water's surface on the recovery, almost coming out of the water, swimming over an imaginary ball of water. They roll over, always swimming downhill on the entry. We can watch it.
200 meters, four lengths of the pool. First start's a good one. This is the first final swim ever for in the Olympics for Mike Barrowman. This is the only event he's in, the 200-meter breaststroke. Barrowman three down from the top, swimming well in the white cap with the American flag. Now coming out quickly in lane six near the bottom is Valery Lozek of the Soviet Union, a 20-year-old. Mike Barrowman up near the top. Barrowman in lane three, three down from the top, swimming off the lead. It's four lengths of the pool as they come to the first turn. They're faster, John, than a world record split. That's been the story of these games here.
The Olympic champion David Wilkie told me that Nick Gillingham from Great Britain is a real candidate. We ought to watch him. He's got a good back half of the race, and he is a top qualifier.
Valery Lozek of the Soviet Union swimming in lane six. Three up from the bottom is swimming in the lead as they conclude the first half of the race. Barrowman of the USA in lane three, swimming off, but he always does swim off. And there is Joseph Nagy, the Hungarian, who coaches three of the swimmers in the race, including Barrowman of the USA and the two Hungarian entrants.
Soviets touched first and second at the halfway point.
They're now slower, John, than a world record split at the halfway point. Lozek going out very strong. He won both the 100-meter and 200-meter breaststrokes at the USSR National Championships.
Joseph Szabo looks like he's really making a push on this third 50. You can see the acceleration currently in second, but look at the way his hands are coming out of the water on that recovery. A rapid turnover is going to help him in this race.
Mike Barrowman's going to do it. He's got to do it now as they make the turn for home. The final 50 meters coming up. And the gold medal swim in the men's 200-meter breaststroke. Joseph Szabo, a 19-year-old from Budapest, Hungary, the top 200-meter breaststroker in the world the last 2 years, is now coming on very hard in the middle of the pool. Szabo in lane five.
Look at that breaststroke. Look at those arms come out. That will become the standard of the stroke in years to come.
Here comes Nick Gillingham from Great Britain challenging. It's going to be Joseph Szabo of Hungary and Gillingham from Great Britain. They can't catch Szabo. Joseph Szabo takes to the wall. Gillingham will get the silver. And the third place finisher is Lopez, coming from off the pace to conclude with a very strong 10-meter swim at the end. Sergio Lopez.
Szabo in the lead. Next to him, Gillingham from Great Britain. Mike Barrowman way back in fourth place. Look at the stroke. Look at the recovery. The hands coming out of the water. Boom, right there. Boom, out of the water it comes. He's swimming downhill when he enters the water and his hands go forward. It requires an extremely powerful kick.